Wait, let's start again.
Hold on, Max. Come back here.
Oh, crap. What does he want? No.
You look a little stressed out.
And we've already told you about him.
I just saw...
Let's try again. Oh, the joy.
Rachel Amber. She looks so hopeful and pretty. I wonder what happened to her. Has been so insane. Everything is happening too fast. And none of it makes any sense. These visions, this power. I keep expecting to wake up one more time. But if this is a dream, then I'm not asleep. Which means somehow I did rewind time. So there has to be a reason, and I have to find out why.
I never mind that. Welcome to part 2 of Life is Strange.
I better read Warren's text before he blows my phone up.
Oh, Warren's text, tremendous. What does he want now?
Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive.
Come on, Logan, bring it, bro. Yeah!
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive.
Oh. Hi, Max.
What are you reading?
Love today or die forever. Don't even say anything.
It's a bestseller. What to say?
Good point. Now, if you'll excuse me.
It's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your waif hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled.
Oh, dude.
Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving.
Oh, wait.
Hold that pose.
Oh, she'll be fucking moving soon.
So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh, dang it, well.
Oh, yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way. I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way.
Mm-hmm. Now for the fun part.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this.
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look
great. Boo-hoo. I can't even what chill shame. On the steps. I must be missing something here.
There goes Samuel da Vinci to paint the window.
Oh, Christ, what am I missing here? I'm definitely missing something, I know that. What am I missing? Oh, wait. What am I missing here? Aha! Temper it!
Okay, let's see if this works.
Off the fun part again.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this.
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah.
Water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this is fucking up my gosh?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Oh, boo-hoo-hoo-hoo. What a fucking shame. Oh, the joy. Now for the fun part. Hello,
no way! No way! Hey, Victoria!
Samuel, sorry.
Oh, boo-hoo-hoo. It's
not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo!
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I drive.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches.
Fucking slut shoes.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
Let's make fun of her for that.
Don't say a word, Max.
Oh, wait. Hold that pose. And no filter needed before I post this. Now, please move. I've had a messed up day and I'm going to my room.
You do that? I know where you live. So does Nathan. No.
Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Now I have to get to my room, then see Warren.
It serves her right for that. It really does serve her right. Boy, that was so funny. I had to make fun of her. It was the best move ever.
Hurry, Courtney!
Room 217? No way in hell am I ever going in here.
I'm pissed we took so long.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Victoria, give me a fucking break.
Warren should be all over Brooke. They're perfect for each other.
Home sweet home. My favorite cocoon. Philip Lorca de Corsia, my man. I don't think I could take my camera to those places. Look at that shot. I love Julia Cameron's Victorian vibe. Talk about analog cameras. Ah, Dolly, what a fantastic eye. He could truly freeze time. I look so pathetic. I am so addicted to this site. Look at these vintage beauties. Warren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real friend here. Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note. Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room. One day I'll organize my film collection. One day I'll get an actual HDTV.
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Oh dear, what's happened now, Dana?
Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell. Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
You are ridiculous.
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Ouch. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet Watson. Duh.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do. Just because I don't talk a lot doesn't mean I don't care. So, how did you find out about them?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext. And Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell. Answer, you wuss. I'm not letting her out until she tells the truth.
Hey, Juliet.
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana.
She's your friend.
Friends don't sex with their best friend's boyfriend.
No, probably not. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last...
Juliet Watson. Duh.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do. Just because I don't talk.
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext. And Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything. But I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her room.
At least that's an alarm from this century. That's real nice, Victoria. And who the hell thinks I'm a hipster? Boom. This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
Jesus Christ. Nothing just in. Shame.
Victoria is a real Jefferson groupie.
Sure. Where is that bloody post?
Victoria hates Rachel Amber this much? How insecure. Victoria is a real Jefferson groupie. Is she going to get a 3D printer for her dorm room? Maybe I will join her posse.
Quite the price, quite the bloody price. Yes, yes, yes.
Yes, Victoria has the best Retina screen laptop. Let me just check to see if she posted my picture.
Leave me alone, Max. Get a clue. Ugh.
What am I missing? What am I missing? Fucking hell.
That's real nice. Boom. This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
I will repeat it. How do we print it?
Yes, I get it. Enter the Vortex Club. No. Okay, if I did wear expensive jewelry, I would wear this for sure.
Where is it?
That's real nice, Victoria. Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
What do we have here?
She's actually got a classic medium format camera with some awesome prime lens. I hate you, Victoria. Let's play a little photo Tetris and leave Victoria a message. Let's move this here. And this one there. a pattern is emerging. Dior, Givenchy, you could pay for my tuition with that wardrobe. This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent. Juliet, read this.
Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Almost done. Get the flash drive and then I'll go see Warren. Of course a popular cheerleader like Dana would have a million friends. So fascinating to get a peek into Dana's social media world. And yes, Max, so terribly wrong.
Let's check that.
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
I better make sure everything is still in there. I think Warren forgot to hide the Party Buster folder. Not that I would open it, no matter how tempting. I have my self-respect.
Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Oh, it sure is.
Victoria is not nice. I don't get it. She has everything. And to pull that prank on a friend?
Just because they're in the Vortex Club doesn't mean they're BFFs. I'm in it, and Victoria creeps me out. Max, you're smart to be a loner here. Though Warren obviously likes hanging with you.
He's a good guy. A geek like me.
You saw the files in his flash drive. Tons of crazy shit. Films I've never even heard of. And in a special folder called Max.
Yeah, okay. I gotcha.
Oh, dear, dear, dear.
This shit.
Ow! That hurt.
Damn, I better rewind.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
Good shot.
Max, that was awesome. Thank you.
No problem. You have quick reflexes.
Years of mad dodging skills. Bullies never change.
Oh, that's why you're better off.
You're smart. We should hang out more. Now I have to finish this stupid book.
What to know?
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Oh dear.
No, and leave me alone.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
I don't get it.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Good for you, Miss. Good for you.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate. I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David...
Interesting. Oh, I'm never used that change. Let's go and see what he wants.
In that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
Yo, Max, check it out.
And there's Warren. Did he actually buy a used car?
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
Man, sure, I saw that Victoria didn't take down that pic of you on Facebook. Major bitch move.
No worries, Warren. I took a sweet shot of Victoria I can't wait to share.
Oh, score one for Team Max. It would be so karmic to see her ass clown face all over the interwebs.
I guess she does deserve it for all the shitty things she's done to people here.
Which is true.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
No, I've been way too busy with class and life.
Damn, girl, you had it like a year.
Or a week. I did browse through all the titles, drama queen.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
Not at all. Sensitive is good, unless you're a pushover. You have hip taste and a quick mind.
Thanks for noticing, Max.
The right girl will too.
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal. Now. Answer me, bitch!
What are you talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal, or that whore
Wait,
in the bathroom!
No. Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody!
Oh well, says the dickhead right. Fucking deserve that twice.
Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
I have no idea. I know he's a Prescott.
And an asshole. Your friend really stood up for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it at my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Hmm.
Come on in. Don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
What a lovely home it is, huh?
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill out zone. My stepfuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height. Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair. Old cardboard boxes.
Dude, you broke my glass snow dough. Thanks.
This postcard is from Rachel Amber. Damn, Chloe does need a lot of money to get out of Arcadia. Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close. It won't play without any power. Now, let's see what kind of music Chloe is into these days. Hey, that TV used to be in the living room. She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned. Who'd have thought Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
Oh, that's too true.
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
Not much. You know me. I like to observe the world more than participate.
I can't say I know you anymore. Maybe you love to go clubbing every night.
Can you see me at a rave?
I'd dose those candy-flipping morons and watch them twitch into a DJ dance death rattle. Take a photo of that.
So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers. I think this junk swallowed her discs.
Hmm.
Now I have the power. Damn, Chloe does need a lot of money to get out of Arcadia. We had such a blast drawing these together.
I know my room is a disaster, but you can find a disc.
Dude, you broke my glass snow dough. Thanks.
And it reeks like dirty laundry. Gross. Nothing but junk in this suitcase.
Where is the disc? Oh, lost.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot, even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
I see why. I bet your mom was not too happy.
She was happy enough to marry a Nazi. Reason number 356 to escape.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago, she just left Arcadia, without a word, without me.
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel, gone. Can you put on some music now?
Oh, indeed we shall.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
cannot see anything. Whoa, dark. I cannot see anything.
What in the light in the moon?
I like Chloe's new hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me. I hope Chloe isn't taking these pills. This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products.
I don't even know anyway.
You can't go home again, said Thomas Wolfe. But here I am. Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days. Nope, someone locked it from the other side. I'd love to go to Paris, too. At this rate, they'll be lucky to get... I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. Brr. I can feel autumn pushing out the summer.
I spark out the link. Now where is the scavenger thing?
Chloe, if you're listening. Pete was cruising home off duty and told me he saw you near that garbage dump. Now I've ordered. Told you to stay away from that place. It's dangerous. Got no idea what kind of scum are living out there. Stay away. I'm serious.
So, where is the...
I should be able to find the tools I need here.
Where do you go then?
These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway.
Oh, we've got files. That's all.
Fingers. Kate Marsh? Why the hell would he have pictures of her? Okay, this is getting totally weird.
Food.
Look at all that food. That's like enough spam for 100 years. Check out the muscle car. Chloe's stepdad must be a gearhead.
Must be renowned. Let's try this one. Switch on.
What the? Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this? One of these guns is missing. I hope Chloe's stepdad isn't packing heat. Yes! Score!
Good scone, dude.
These are way too big. Nothing. This is so lame. Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get? Chloe's stepdad is a veteran and a security guard? He must really hate her. Boom, precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Man, I should have done that before they fell. Yes, you have mad skills, Max. I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera.
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Booyah, you skank. Karma's a bitch. Nice framing, too. Wait, I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max. I was there, hiding in the corner. Damn, you're a ninja. A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo. That is so badass. Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
I wasn't sure.
I know I look a lot different.
I was scared too. I couldn't see straight.
I don't blame you, Max.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit.
There's no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Absolutely. Nathan Prescott had a fucking gun on you.
Gutless prick. That was scary. Who did you tell?
The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max.
Oh, my joy. Oh, the joy. Joy, joy. Oh, you're going to be tired.
I, know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that bony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera.
This day couldn't get any stranger.
This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
Yo, turn it off. Turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on! Asshole.
One thing.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in, now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in, now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe, open this door.
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you. One of my guns is missing.
Oh, boo-hoo-hoo.
Did you take it?
Oh, God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh, yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order.
Oh, shame.
Whose is it?
I'm sorry. That was my joint.
Well, well. I don't like strangers in my home. Especially dopers. So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police?
that screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. You don't have anything smart to say now, do you?
Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
I was a soldier, Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Because you're such a badass, Max, let me show you my new toy. I'm Price. Chloe Price. Bang!
Jesus, put that thing down.
Chillax, sister. It's not even loaded. Yet.
I thought you believed in gun control.
Yes, I believe I should control the gun. It's the men who need to be checked. You trust Nathan or David? Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win. Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
Man, that did not go well for me. If I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody, even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
Oh well, never mind. Oh dear, dear. Well, I'll see you on part 3. Bye-bye.